Threshold regressions are a type of non-linear time series model that allow for regime switching. The coefficients of the model are constant in each regime but can change between regimes. The switch from one regime to another is triggered by a specific observed data series. One of the goals of threshold model estimation is to find the value or values of the data series that trigger the regime change. EViews offers standard threshold autoregression, TAR estimation, as well as the associated CTAR and STAR models. As an example, we will use data containing annual sunspot counts from 1700 to 1988. These data were similarly analysed by, amongst many others, Bruce Hansen in his 1999 paper, Testing for Linearity. We have these data in the series Sunspots in our work file. Following his example, we can take a square root transformation of the data via the EViews command line. We can estimate a simple TAR model by clicking on Quick, Estimate Equation, then changing the estimation method to Threshold. Following Hansen's example, we will use up to 11 lags of the dependent variable as threshold regressors and a constant as a non-varying regressor. We will estimate a self-exciting TAR model with 2 lags by typing in 2 in the threshold variable specification. Clicking OK produces the output results. The top part of the output shows a summary of the estimation performed, including the time and date, number of observations, and the selected threshold value, 7.44 in this case. The main part of the output provides the coefficient estimates of the regressors in each regime. Since we have 2 regimes in our example, we have 2 sets of coefficients. At the bottom, we can see the non-regime specific coefficient on the constant. The last section of the output contains the standard regression summary statistics, including R squared and the F statistic. In this example, we fix the number of thresholds at 1, leading to 2 regimes. If, instead, we would like EViews to determine the number of regimes, we can bring up the estimation dialog again and switch to the Options tab to change the threshold specification settings. We can change the method of threshold determination to global L thresholds versus none, with a maximum of 5 breaks. Clicking OK again produces the results, and we can see that we now have 5 threshold values, 5.27, 8.41, 11.42, 14.06, and 16.64. These thresholds lead to 6 regimes, and so we have 6 sets of coefficient values. So far, we've set the threshold variable as a 2-period lag of the dependent variable. If we aren't precisely sure on which variable or how many lags to use for the threshold variable, we can instruct EViews to test different specifications and choose the best one. We'll ask EViews to choose between various lag values by entering them into the threshold variable specification box on the estimation dialog. We can see that EViews selected a lag of 5 as the most appropriate lag specification, using a residual sum of squares criteria. We can view RSS values for each of the lag specifications by clicking on View, Model Selection Summary, Criteria Table. Here we see that the 5 lag model is clearly superior to the other lag specifications.